Your Excellency, former President Olusegun Obasanjo, Your Excellency, President of Uganda, represented by the Honorable Minister, all other protocols observed. It gives me great pleasure to welcome all of you distinguished ladies and gentlemen to this third edition of the World Pension Summit, Africa Special, taking place here in Abuja today. The theme of this year's summit, as has been said earlier, is Pension Innovations, the Africa Perspective. Distinguished delegates and all accomplished professionals here present would agree with me that Africa is indeed at a critical turning point in its history. After a long period of faltering economic performance, there has been resurgent growth over the last decade, with the continent recording on average a 5% increase in GDP. This renaissance has been, amongst other things, essentially sustained by unique African entrepreneurial and innovative spirit. The success stories of emerging industries and smaller innovative initiatives such as the portable irrigation technology helping sub-Saharan Africa smallholder farmers grow crops out of season. These innovations undoubtedly provide the foundations for transforming the continent over the next decades. A recent World Bank report on Africa's demographics, which was published in 2015, states that countries in sub-Saharan Africa have experienced impressive and sustained economic growth and development over the past 15 years. Child mortality has dropped in most countries, and infertility rates have reduced significantly for educated women living in urban areas. This has resulted in a rapidly growing population, with estimates showing that the region will become a much larger part of the global population, with a projected 2.8 billion people by 2060. This exponential milestone is expected to translate to a population of healthy, educated and empowered labor force that will engender sustainable economic growth and poverty reduction. Africa would, therefore, need to address the issue of aging population that will emerge as the demographic transition comes to an end by developing robust pension and social security systems to cater for old age income. Then again, cutting-edge infrastructure is critical for economic growth and social progress. Extant indices show that Africa's infrastructure remains by far the most deficient and costly among developing countries. In many cities, the challenge of urbanization and the need for modern infrastructure is already evident. One third of urban residents in sub-Saharan Africa are located in 36 cities, each with more than 1 million inhabitants. The United Nations estimated that by 2025, the population in Lagos and Kinshasa will reach 18.9 million and 14 million, respectively. To put this in context, it will be the equivalent of combining the current populations of London, Berlin, Madrid, which stand at 15.4 million based on 2015 population figures. Bridging Africa's infrastructure deficit would therefore require sustained spending of about US $93 billion per annum, which translates to about 15% of Africa's GDP. This huge challenge, I believe, can be surmounted by a coordinated, multifaceted approach to development and the integration of domestic funding sources, such as pension funds and foreign institutional investors. The foregoing interplay of events, ladies and gentlemen, to a great extent influenced the choice of this year's theme, which I believe will resonate with delegates and is meant to provide a platform for the exchange of ideas and experiences on innovative practices in pensions and social security to advance the African agenda of addressing economic and social challenges. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as I welcome you to this summit, I would like to leave you with a few poses. How do we build deep and efficient capital markets and financing models that will enable institutional investors such as pension funds to invest in infrastructure? How can pension fund managers in Africa mainstream environmental, social and governance principles in their investment decisions with a view to promoting sustainable, impactful investments? How do pension fund managers and regulators leverage technology to stimulate the impact of pensions in our socioeconomic systems? What specific action steps can be taken today to begin the process of developing these practices? Distinguished experts, delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I am quite confident that these and other issues will be thoroughly deliberated and practical solutions provided over the next 2 days. As we go into the plenaries, we will also look back on the takeaways from last year's summit and give a report on where we have reached and where we are heading to from the events of the summit. And I implore each and everyone present to contribute to the deliberation geared towards achieving the objectives of entrenching sustainable pensions and social security systems in all of Africa. Thank you for your attention.
She delivered the welcome in a very short time. For her timeliness and the urgency of her delivery, can we give her another round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you very much. Let me very specially also welcome here the Director General of PTAD, Ms. Sharon Ikezo. I welcome you very specially. Also here, the Presidents of NLC and TUC, the Honorable Minister for Mauritania, Mauritius, is also here with us. The Director General of DMO and the representative of Honorable Minister of Labour is also here with us. I welcome all of you. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is said that there's no speed limit to excellence. Great things are done, but not by impulse, but by a series of small things put together. And the next speaker knows this. He has nurtured the World Pension Summit like a lovely baby till now. It was a global forum. Today we have the Africa Special. I'd like to welcome here one of the co-founders of the World Pension Summit, Mr. Eric Egging, to please step forward here.